Namaste everyone, this is Niharika Rajpoor. I'm a wildlife artist specializing in building intricate paper sculptures of birds and animals. I'm extremely happy to be collaborating with the Kiran Nagar Museum for today's workshop. Since today is World Bird Migratory Day, it's only fitting that we learn how to build a sculpture of one such migratory bird. So, without any further ado, let's get started.
Today we will be building a green-crowned brilliant hummingbird. For that, you will require regular epoxy, which is M-Seal. This can be purchased from any hardware store. The first step is to basically mix the resin and hardener in equal proportions, to a point where the resin completely dissolves into the hardener and you get a clear black mixture. Roll it up into a ball and keep it aside for a minute or two before you start working on it. I usually start by sculpting the beak of the bird. In order to do that, take a little portion from the ball, pinch it with the tips of your finger and try to pull it outwards very gently. Apply equal pressure on all sides. Since the hummingbird has a long and thin beak, I will also be inserting a piece of wire inside. Once you're satisfied with how the beak looks, start sculpting the body of the bird. Try to create a depression under the throat by pushing the clay inwards. By doing so, you're automatically going to get a nice rounded belly. Then start working on the head, try to round up the head, and slowly try to narrow down the tail portion. Once you're happy with the symmetry of the bird and the proportions, you move on to making some holes in the bird's body. Use a needle or any such sharp object to make two big holes closer to the tail area. These holes are basically going to be for the talons. Make sure the holes are big enough and wide enough. Make two smaller holes or around the tail area to insert a piece of wire which will act as an inner structure for the tail. Now roll up two smaller balls out of the same mix for the eyes of the bird. Then use the back of a paintbrush, preferably size 0, to create two smaller depressions on either side of the head of the bird. Next up, we will be attaching a few pieces of wire to the bird's body in order to build the talons and the tail. Preferably use wire that is thin, especially for this project. Cut up 8 pieces of wire for the talons. Insert 4 pieces of wire in one big hole which we made closer to the tail portion and the other 4 wire in the other hole. Take another small piece of wire and make it into an elongated U. Insert this wire in the 2 holes that you made around the tail portion. This will act as an inner structure for the tail. Attach the pieces of wire using Fevikwik or Araldite. If you are using Araldite, leave it to dry overnight. Once you've attached all the pieces of wire to the bird's body, let's start working on the talons. Use a nose plier and try to twist the 4 pieces of wire in one direction. Do this slowly. Once you're satisfied with the length of the leg and how long you want to keep the talons, use a pair of scissors to trim off the excess. Once you've trimmed off the excess, try to curl up the talons using the nose plier. Do this to get the right shape. Once the talons are ready, cover it up in regular epoxy and give it the right kind of texture using a needle or any such sharp object. This is how the talon will look once it's covered in epoxy. The next step can be a little tricky. Start by sketching the wing feather and the tail feather in as much detail as possible for the bird that you have chosen. Try to study different photographs taken from different angles and different postures that you are working on before you start sketching. it is important that everything is sketched in the right proportions. Once you are satisfied with the size of the wing feather and the tail feather and the details, start cutting out each feather individually using a pair of scissors and try to complete the feather using a pencil. Once you do that, your stencils will be ready to use. Individual stencils for all the feathers, such as the primary feathers, secondary feathers, alula, quartet, down feathers, everything has to be cut out individually. Once the stencils are ready, start sketching them on a piece of paper that you have selected to build the paper feathers for the bird. Next up, select a pastel sheet in your desired color. And if you can't find a sheet in your desired color, try to paint your own paper. Since all the stencils are ready, try to sketch out all the wing feathers and tail feathers onto your paper. Cut them out individually using a pair of scissors. Once all the wing feathers and tail feathers are cut out, now we just need to glue them to the body of the bird. I usually start by building the tail of the bird. Try to use the tail stencil that you created earlier as your reference point. See how the feathers overlap each other. Also try to understand the placement of the feathers. Once the tail feathers are glued on to the bird's body, I start cutting out the body feathers. Next up, we will be building our body feathers. In order to do so, take the stencil of the body feather, place it onto the piece of paper you will be using, and take a pencil to draw an outline of the stencil. Do so multiple times and cut out each feather using a pair of scissors. As we move from bottom to top, the size of the body feather keeps becoming smaller. Cutting up paper feathers for the bird's body is the most important part. Use a pair of scissors with sharp blades. Hold the paper feather in your hand and start cutting from top to bottom. Basically, it's a repetitive action. Repeat the process for the rest of the feathers and glue them to the bird's body. Once you reach the throat portion on the bird's body, we start building the wing feathers. Refer to the wing stencil that you drew earlier and try to number all your feathers. When you number all your feathers, it becomes easier to understand where you are going to be placing your feathers. I usually start from the bottom and move upwards. And once I'm finished with the primary and secondary feathers, I start working on the smaller feathers and move from right to left. I follow the same process for the entire wing and then do the same on the other side. The last step is to paint the bird. I usually prefer using Fevicryl's acrylic paints. And in this case, since we are building a hummingbird, you'll also require some iridescent paints. You can order these online. Before you start painting the bird, try to get a good understanding of the texture and color of the plumage and how the sunlight acts upon the plumage. I usually prefer using a size 00 brush to paint a bird of this size. And I do dry brushing without using too much water to get best results. I've used two different shades of green, purple, brown, black, and golden iridescent paints for this particular bird. So this is how a paper sculpture of a green-crowned brilliant hummingbird looks like when it's all done.